61A, Lecture Number 2, Announcements. Announcements appear here at the top of cs61a.org, and they should be updated before every lecture. They tell you what's going on in the course. If you ever want to see older announcements, just click on the older button. Lab 0 has a due date, but you should ignore that and work on Lab 0 right now. It's just a guide to help set up your computer for the course. Please try it before you arrive at lab next week. If you don't get all the way through, that's okay. You can get help while you're in lab. But there's a whole Lab 1 assignment during lab next week, so it's really best if you finish Lab 0 before you get there. Lab 1 will be the first in-person lab. And the idea behind a lab is that you show up in a room full of computers, you can bring your own if you want, and you work through a bunch of example problems with course staff in the room to help you out if you get stuck, and other students in the room if you want to collaborate. These lab assignments are due every Wednesday, but really you should try to finish them while you're in your lab section. That's how they're designed. So these aren't another take-home assignment that you have to do every week. They're just something that you do while you're in lab. Now you could do them on your own, but I strongly recommend that you actually come to lab and work on them there, because that's how you'll learn the most. And you can definitely work with other students on lab assignments, but the whole point of a lab assignment is for you to learn enough about the week's material that you can solve the homework, and so you gotta understand the solutions before you leave. And next Thursday, homework 1 is due. In fact, it's already posted. Now, if you listen to today's lecture, you won't actually know enough to solve the whole homework, because questions 4 through 6 depend on next Monday's lecture, lecture number 3. This is an unusually compressed schedule. Normally, homework will just cover the previous week's lectures, you'll get to learn a little bit more about those topics in lab, and then you solve the homework. But it's good to get going in this course. So this homework is about lecture material from today and Monday. Homework in this course is not just to check that you've been paying attention. It involves learning new things and trying out some problem solving. So if you read a homework question and you don't know how to solve it right away, that's normal. Think about it for a while. You're welcome to talk to your friends. You're welcome to talk to the course staff. And this button office hours up here is a way for you to get connected with course staff in order to get them to help you out. But the most important thing to know about homework is that you should read it shortly after it's released. Don't wait until the day it's due to read the homework. You might not be able to solve it, and even if you do solve it then with lots of help, you'll get in trouble because you won't fully understand the problem-solving process. So instead, read it when it comes out, think through the problems. If you can't solve them right away, that's fine. Go to lab, learn a little bit about simpler problems that are similar, and then you might be able to solve the homework. If you still can't solve it on your own, that's no problem at all, but at least you'll have given yourself a chance to think about it, and then you can get some help from the course staff or from other people in the course. This is the first video recorded lecture. It's actually multiple YouTube videos. So there's one announcements video, but then there's a whole playlist where each video is about a different topic, and there's usually 4 or 5 to a lecture. Not all the videos are recorded new this semester. In fact, almost all of them will have been recorded for previous semesters. Because if I don't have something new to say about a topic, then I don't record a new video, I just play the old one. I will make new videos or re-record old videos anytime course content is changing. And the course does change over time. We tweak it a little bit every semester. So, if you watch the videos and you find, you know, one of them was made in my apartment in San Francisco back in 2013, don't be surprised. That's not an error. That's just the course content that happens to have not changed at all. I'll work on the video lectures, and Pamela's going to teach live Zoom lectures every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. We'll try to cover the same content, but we do use different examples and sometimes different teaching techniques. You shouldn't have to watch the video lectures and go to live Zoom lecture, but you totally can. It's really up to you to figure out how best to learn the material. So our goal as lecturers is to make sure that if you watch all the videos I'm making, or go to all of Pamela's lectures, or some mixture of the two, you can still get all of the course content. It's not like you have to work hard to figure out who said what. We'll both say the same thing. And there's a really good third option, which is that there will be recordings of Pamela's live Zoom lectures. So if you can't attend or don't attend for some reason, but you still want to hear what she said and what questions were asked and how they were answered, they will be listed as lecture recordings. Now, for lecture one, there were no video lectures, but for lectures two and onward, there will be video lectures in addition to the lecture recordings and the live lectures. It's up to you to figure out how you want to learn this stuff. I hope that's not too confusing. We just did it this way to give you options because some students like the live experience and some students like the videos, and so you have both. All right, let's dive into the content.